I think what's fascinating to me is that, you know, while we all have these uniquely different paths in the coaching sphere, you all have a shared connection through the NESCAC conference. And I know, Don, you're sort of at the base of this coaching tree here, having coached Mark at Tufts and mentored both Adam and Peter. So my next question is just, how have you guys helped mentor one another through your experience in the NESCAC? And Don, I'll start with you here.
Well, that's a good question, because without even Pete and Adam and Mark knowing it, I've reached out to them so many times throughout my career for advice, for help and support. And the support they have given me through emails, personal visits, it has been inspiring. It really has. And luckily, I'm still in contact with so many of my former swimmers, even from my first year. I heard yesterday from Brian Herrick about an Achilles issue that he has. He graduated with Mark in 96, and we talk as if he graduated yesterday, and along many, many of his classmates. So they've mentored me, me being their friend, and they in return have expressed a friendship. As I said, that's Jim Steen's induction ceremony a couple of weeks ago. It is a blessing, and it is beyond extraordinary. It really is. It's a wonderful life.
I'll tail off of that and just say, you know, watching and talking, and so connecting with these guys on the screen, but also the other coaches in the conference, we just have that mutual respect, but also that friendship that enables us to pick up the phone, talk on deck about the all the highs and all the lows, right? We've hit some pretty high peaks and some low valleys over the years, and no better people to turn to than the folks on this screen right here, and even within the other coaches of the conference, just to figure out, kind of opinions or best approaches based on their experience. But yeah, I would say, we'll get into this a little bit later, but that is what makes this conference so unique, is I would say that camaraderie that we all share.
Yeah, I'd like to just get onto that idea. I know obviously Coach has been a huge mentor, and we've been in close contact for 20 plus years and on any and all topics, but also, and Peter, with you retiring this year, I've always said the voice of reason in the conference that just retired, so we're gonna need to reassess some things, I think. But you can always count on Peter to deliver a very calm and calculated approach to whatever it is we were talking about, but really, I think the camaraderie in our conference I think is really neat. It's I still remember my very first year. Our guys had always finished 11th out of 11 in the NESCAC. We were the perennial doormat, and we were fighting it out with Trinity for 10th. I remember Steve Custer, the Williams coach, coming over midway through the NESCAC meet, and he's like, "You think you're going to get him? Like, how, he was all into it." And it was super exciting for him. And I'm like, this guy is about to win his bajillionth NESCAC title here, and he cares about the 10th, 11th place battle going on. Like, okay, that's how this is. I get it now. And it just really was cool, that sort of introduction to it all. I've tried to pay that forward, everybody's just the investment in each other's success, I think, has been really cool to see over the years. It's just been great when any of the NESCAC schools, do well. We feel, I think, a little sense of pride across the board.
Yeah, God, you guys have.
On that note, Mark, do you remember the times like we would, again, be in our own little battles, but we'd come back from trials, come back at finals at night, and we'd already scored out the evening, and how that was going to reflect on, and Mark had the meet calculated, back in April, but, we would compare notes in terms of what the point spreads were going to look like at the end of the night. And just again, I was just as interested in how Mark's battles were going as the battles our teams were going through.
Yeah, I can just speak from my own personal experience. I think when, you know, I was hired as an interim head coach, head coaching the men's team at Tufts, you know, within this conference, all the coaches, you know, were looking out for me, were encouraging to me, were positive, were supportive, were helping me to succeed. And that has continued on. I mean, I still think of myself as the young guy and the inexperienced guy in the conference. And now I've been here for 20 years and 23, if you count the time at Trinity. So it's just always been a friendly group of coaches who, you know, ultimately share the same mission, the same goal of helping young people swim fast, dive well, and get a great education and grow. And I think because of that, you know, it's just nice. We all have a seat at the table. Everyone, you know, gets a vote on different things. Our conference office, for the most part, is, you know, presents in a way where they're interested in our opinion. Our director of athletics, you know, they're allowing us to contribute. So, you know, we feel like we have a little skin in the game and we're not just being told what to do. And it's not just about swimming and diving. It's also about, you know, education and personal growth and development. And that shared mission within a conference, I think, is rare. I think most conferences, you're going to see a pretty wide strata of types of schools with different mission statements as it relates to athletics. And I would say in the NESCAC, we're pretty much, regardless of where we're finishing, we're pretty much on par with what the mission is, what we're trying to accomplish.